Hello everyone, this is Thomas Kincaid, the Painter of Light. Hey, I tell you what, I am so excited to welcome you into my studio. And so I present to you at this time my brand new painting, Pinocchio Wishes Upon a Star. Now I call these paintings narrative panoramas because these are not just recreations of a given scene from the movie. This is not just a clip or a setting or an exact moment from the film. This is a recreation of the entire panorama of the story. It is the narrative, all told in one visual form. So this painting is the second piece in my Disney Dreams collection. These are my daydreams of the places and the worlds envisioned by Walt Disney, but reinterpreted as a Thomas Kincaid painting.
The starting point of the Pinocchio image is Pinocchio himself. We see him on a mountaintop overlooking the village where he came to life. In the middle foreground, we see the central conflict of the Pinocchio story, which is the element of temptation and redemption. In this case, temptation is embodied by the comic character of Honest John and his sidekick. You see them making their way up the cobblestone path. At Pinocchio's side is his own sidekick, Jiminy Cricket, who serves as the moral counterbalance in the story. Hovering in the sky above them is the blue fairy, who presides over the scene as an otherworldly apparition. She becomes the presence of grace in the movie. In the central mid-distance, we see Geppetto's workshop. Geppetto is a creative individual surrounding himself with the works of his own hands. Beyond Geppetto's workshop, we see Stromboli's stage, and the master puppeteer is upon the stage getting ready to conduct a showing. There are hidden details throughout the painting, and the crowd of onlookers for Stromboli's show provided me with a couple opportunities for hidden elements. You'll see Disneyland balloons being held by members of the crowd, and you might even see a familiar face or two. As we venture beyond the mountain village, we see the coastal village that is the setting of the greatest time of temptation for Pinocchio. Above the wharf, we see the bridge over which the boys are crossing in the carriage, being driven by the evil wagon master who is taking the boys to their destiny. The boat will sail across the waters of the bay and arrive at Pleasure Island, which is itself bedecked with lights and getting ready for another day of providing temptation to the boys. In the mid-distance, we see Geppetto's sailing vessel with Geppetto himself at the steering wheel. If you look real carefully, perhaps this would take a magnifying glass, but you will see Geppetto's companions, the kitten Figaro, and of course Cleo in her fishbowl. Of course, there are obstacles, as we see in the case of Monstro the whale, who is attempting to gobble up Geppetto and his sailboat. Coming back to a more general view of the composition, we are aware of the light and the sparkling of the sunrise or sunset as it bounces off the waves. People have asked about the butterflies, and it is true they don't appear in the story, but they are included as a suggestion of the magical nature of the Pinocchio story. I think this painting required over 300 hours of studio time, all the research that was done at the Thomas Kincaid Studios, the working with the archive, researching the original sketchwork and designs that were part of Gustav Tengren's plan for Pinocchio. Pinocchio is part of the Disney Dozen, so named because there will be 12 paintings in the first grouping of images created to tributize the great moment from Walt Disney Films. These paintings are more than just scenes from the movie. They are really meant to be a collaboration between the artistic vision of Walt Disney and the artistic vision of Thomas Kincaid, as I attempt to carry forward that same sense of wide-eyed wonder that Walt Disney wanted to portray. There are hidden Mickeys in the painting. You can find those for yourself. There are hidden ends, 25 of them, in the painting to celebrate my 25th year as a published artist. There are five hearts in the painting, representative of the five women and girls in my life, my beautiful wife, Nanette, and of course our four daughters, Merritt, Chandler, Windsor, and Everett. Each of these girls gets her own heart, and of course Nanette gets a heart as well as the hidden ends that symbolize my partnership with my wife.
Well, it all gets down to dreams, doesn't it? The dreams that I have as an artist, the dreams that we have as human beings, because I think we all daydream about the same things: home, family, a sense of meaning in life. And even though this is a painting about a puppet, it is a painting about life, because the puppet at the end of the story comes to life and he is able to wish upon a star and dream of greater things. In a sense, that's really my goal as an artist, to remind us all to dream. As a pastor said to me one time, he said, "Tom, your paintings are like a daydream brought to life." I love that quote. Like a daydream that we all share brought to life. This is Thomas Kincaid again thanking you for wishing upon a star and making your own dreams come true. God bless.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. If your heart is in your dream, no request is too